Hello students, in the second chapter of life processes, you have studied respiration, cell division, etc. Now in this chapter, let's study about one of the most important life processes of living organisms, that is reproduction. Students, do you know what reproduction is? Why is it necessary? How do organisms look alike and different at the same time? Let's find out answers to these questions. Reproduction is the process by which parents give rise to next generation or new individuals of same kind. Due to reproduction, new individuals are added to the population and thus species continues to live on the earth. Also, sufficient number of organisms avoid species extinction. The two types of cell division are studied by you earlier, namely mitosis and meiosis. They play an important role in reproduction. When new generation is formed by mitosis involving only one parent, it is referred as asexual reproduction. Here, the new organisms formed are identical to their parents in the characteristics. On the other hand, in sexual reproduction, there are two parents, namely male and female, or father and mother. They produce haploid gametes by meiosis. These gametes unite to produce diploid zygote. The new generation is formed from zygote. Here, the offsprings show some characteristics common with their parents, but also show genetic variations. Both reproduction types have advantages and limitations. In asexual reproduction, the multiplication rate is rapid, but offsprings do not show genetic variations. As only one parent is involved, new characteristics cannot be introduced. On the other hand, in sexual reproduction, though reproduction rate is slower, offsprings possess characteristics of two parents. There is genetic variation. These individuals adapt better to the changes in their surroundings. Hence, chances of survival of species are more, avoiding its extinction. This leads to diversity among animals. Let's try to understand this concept of diversity through simple examples. Different flower colors in hibiscus or rose, different shapes of leaves in the plants, etc. Asexual reproduction. It usually occurs in old or primitive organisms like bacteria, Paramecium, Euglena, amoeba, etc. These organisms reproduce by various asexual methods such as binary or longitudinal or transfer fission. These methods occur when conditions are favorable such as abundance of water and food. However, these organisms do reproduce asexually during unfavorable conditions as well. It is called multiple fission. In this process, organism is protected by a thick cover called cyst. Inside the cyst, many daughter organisms are produced by mitotic divisions. Later, on the return of favorable conditions, cyst breaks to release new organisms. Budding. Organisms like Hydra and yeast reproduce by budding. The parent organism produces a bud or protuberance. It gradually grows into a young organism and then separates from the parent. Fragmentation. Spirogyra, Cycon, and many other filamentous organisms reproduce by fragmentation. The parent organism breaks into pieces or fragments. These fragments grow as separate individuals. Regeneration. In Planaria, parent animal breaks into two pieces. Each part then regenerates the remaining body to form two new organisms. Spore formation. In many fungi, asexual spores are produced. They germinate to produce new fungal colony. Vegetative propagation. In many plants like potato, sweet potato, bryophyllum, there are adventitious buds on roots, stems and leaves, which sprout into new plants. Sexual reproduction. Students, we have talked briefly about reproduction methods earlier. Now, let's study this process that occurs in higher plants and animals. Process of sexual reproduction involves following steps. Male and female parents produced gametes by meiosis. Gametes unite or fuse to form zygote. This is called fertilization. Zygote is the first call of next generation. It divides to form embryo. D. Finally, a new organism is formed from cells of embryo. The next generation shows genetic diversity as compared to the parents. This can be well understood with the following example. If comparison among family members is done, you will realize that each one differs from the other in terms of appearance, intelligence, aptitude, etc. Though some features are common in all of them. Thank you.